بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The sacred month of Ramadan, the peak of worship and servitude. It is not possible for man to flee away from the path of servitude. No moment of his life is free from this. This servitude can be of two types. It's either right or wrong. If man's servitude was correct, that is, if he truly follows the path of prosperity of his Lord, then all of his abilities, his talents, his awareness, his knowledge, it will blossom. As a result, from the low earthly limited being, a divine spiritual connected to the Almighty God with endless qualities and attributes is made. The Almighty says, يَبْنَ آدَمْ أَنَا غَنِيٌّ لَا أَفْتَقِرْ أَطِعْنِي فِي مَا أَمَرْتُكْ أَجْعَلُكَ غَنِيًّا لَا تَفْتَقِرْ. O sons of Adam, I am the rich, the needless. Obey me as I have commanded you. I will make you rich, needless. يَبْنَ آدَمْ أَنَا حَيٌّ لَا أَمُوتُ أَطِعْنِي فِي مَا أَمَرْتُكْ أَجْعَلُكَ حَيًّا لَا تَمُوتُ. O sons of Adam, I am the living who never dies. Obey me as I have commanded you. I will make you living who never dies. يَبْنَ آدَمْ أَنَا أَقُولُ لِشَيْءٍ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ أَطِعْنِي فِي مَا أَمَرْتُكَ أَجْعَلُكَ تَقُولُ لِشَيْءٍ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. O sons of Adam, I say to a thing, be, it becomes. Obey me as I have commanded you. I will make you say, be, to a thing, and it will become. The evil effects of wrong servitude. If man falls into the traps of wrong servitude, worshipping Tawhut, the arrogance, his carnal desires, all his talents, his high aspirations will shut, and as a result will become the most notorious creature on earth. In this regard, the Almighty says, إِنَّ شَرَّ الدَّوَّابِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ السُّمُّ الْبُكْمُ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. Surely the unworthy of animals in Allah's sight are the deaf, the dumb, who do not understand. An existence evil, low, wretched and deprived, such that other creatures will see nothing but evil and loss. When his servitude and worshipping is wrong, he will have no mercy to those nearest to him, even his wife and children. Not that he would not provide their maintenance, he may support them in the best possible way, but spiritually he will hurt them severely. Because when the head of the family is on the wrong satanic path, the members he supports will be misled and astray. Although each member of the household is responsible for his actions himself and must perform their duties in the best possible way, but the performance of the head of the family does affect the family. A father does play an important part in molding and building the personality of his wife and children, as they think him to be the right. And for such fathers, who are in fact traitors, Quran says, their wives and children will complain, saying, وَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّا أَطَعْنَا سَادَتَنَا وَكُبَرَاءَنَا فَأَضَلُّونَ السَّبِيلَ. And they shall say, O our Lord, surely we obeyed our leaders and our great men, so they led us astray from the path. Or elsewhere says, رَبَّنَا آتِهِمْ ضِعْفَيْنِ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ وَلْعَنْهُمْ لَعْنًا كَبِيرًا. O our Lord, give them a double punishment and curse them with a great curse. Deviating an individual is a grave sin, equal to killing a soul. The Ahadith say qatl in this verse is not just murder, but the killing of the intellect, killing of nature, demise of one's soul, or in simple words, being deprived and held back from every perfection. A false worship is the death and destruction of true human realities, death of man himself, and the destruction of every education and elevation of other members of the community. Man has never seen a sin greater and more dangerous than this. The glorious Quran says, مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَكِأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكِأَنَّمَا أَحْيَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. Whosoever kills a soul, unless it be for manslaughter or for mischief in the land, it is as though he killed all men. And whoever keeps it alive, it is as though he kept alive all men. Imam Baqir alayhi salam says, one who listens to a person and practices as indeed worshipped him. If he heard from the right source and practices, indeed he worshipped Haqq. And if not, he has indeed worshipped falsehood. The orators, speakers, could be of two kinds: true, wise, just, knowledgeable, with insight and caring, or liars, traitors, deceiving and misleading. The Almighty God is an existence possessing all attributes of perfection, and there is no one like Him who wants the welfare and the prosperity of both the worlds for His creation. To arrive at perfection, one needs to seek assistance from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, a ma'soom imam alayhi salam, and a just jurist, a faqih, possessing the right conditions. The Prophet and the imams to interpret the Holy Quran, and the faqih to interpret and inform the ahadith through his ijtihad. That is why Imam Baqir alayhi salam says, مَنْ أَصْغَى إِلَىٰ نَاطِقٍ فَقَدْ عَبَدَهُ فَإِنْ كَانَ النَّاطِقُ يُؤَدِّي عَنِ اللَّهِ فَقَدْ عَبَدَ اللَّهِ وَإِنْ كَانَ النَّاطِقُ يُؤَدِّي عَنِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَقَدْ عَبَدَ الشَّيْطَانِ. By listening and by practicing the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, the Imams alayhim as-salam, and the Fuqaha, the Mujtahids, one has indeed worshipped God, as the Almighty mentions in the glorious book, مَنْ يُطِعَ الرَّسُولُ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. Whosoever obeys the Messenger, he indeed obeys Allah. If one does not listen to the commands of God, he ends up responding to his own desires and the desires of others, and ends being a slave of others. Terms like a slave of desires, a slave of the world, a slave of his belly, a slave of wealth, a slave of taghut, can be seen a lot in the Holy Quran and the teachings of Ahlulbayt alayhim as-salam. Freeing from the slavery and servitude of God will make man end being a slave in servitude of shaitan. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَوْلِيَاؤُهُمُ الطَّاغُوتِ. And as to those who disbelieve, their guardians are shaitans. Or أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَاهُ. Have you then considered him who takes his low desires for his God? A divine month has approached. We have to make the best of every moment of this sacred month as the prosperity of a lifetime. But the prosperity of our hereafter is in this month. We have to be smart. We have to be vigilant. In servitude and worship of the Almighty God, He has said, أَصَّوْمُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. That is, the fast is mine, and I will reward for it. Elsewhere says, أَصَّوْمُ لِي وَأَنَا جَزَاؤُهُ. That is, fasting is mine, and I am the reward. If in this sacred month of Ramadan, the inputs to the soul and the soul itself, it must be under control. To none must one submit, to none but Allah must one bow. He the Glorious says, O sons of Adam, I am the rich, the needless, obey me. As I have commanded you, I will make you rich, needless. O sons of Adam, I am the living who never dies, obey me. As I have commanded you, I will make you living who never dies. O sons of Adam, I say to a thing, be, it becomes. Obey me, as I have commanded you, I will make you say, be, to a thing, and it will become.
سبحانك يا الله تعاليت يا رحمن أجرنا من النار يا مجيب.
It is not possible for man to flee away from the path of servitude. No moment of his life is free from this. This servitude can be of two types.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The sacred month of Ramadan, the peak of worship and his talents, his awareness, his knowledge, it will blossom. As a result from the low earthly limited being, a divine spiritual connected to the Almighty God with endless qualities and attributes is made. The Almighty says, يَبْنَ آدَمْ أَنَا غَنِيٌّ لَا أَفْتَقِرْ أَطِعْنِي فِي مَا أَمَرْتُكْ أَجْعَلُكَ غَنِيًّا لَا تَفْتَقْرْ. It's either right or wrong. If man's servitude was correct, that is, if he truly follows the path of prosperity of his Lord, then all of his abilities, his